Valentine's Day often means red desserts. We're joined by Miriam Pearl, owner of Delicious Without Gluten. Hi, welcome.
Hi, Tina.
So, first of all, you brought some delicious gluten-free, allergen-free treats. But most importantly is that this is all natural dyes. You've stayed away from synthetic dyes. Why should we consider staying away from synthetic dyes?
You know, celiac disease is something that everybody talks about like as if it's a fad, right?
It's
but
not.
Really, we're talking about gut health. And I have two kids with celiac, and I devote my life to making recipes that are all good for you and non-GMO. And having when you can have something that is fun and delicious and you can also make it healthy,
why not?
This is a great reason.
Okay, so you've brought some beets as a way to put in some dye. So how would that work?
So beets, you can roast the beets or you can buy them already prepared in a health food store, a regular store. Everybody has them now. And they give a lot of color, whether you you can grate them, crush them with a food processor, or use the beet juice. This is the beet juice over here that we have.
Okay.
And it's beautiful in color.
I love that color.
It gives a really nice purplish, not so much red, but you'll see the final
on
product.
On these crepes, they're just beautiful. Okay,
yeah.
And this is one of the first recipes you're gonna put me to work
so
here.
This is like my daughter's favorite recipe. It's crepes. We love crepes in our house. And I decided that we're gonna make them with beets this time. So I'll make this, and I'm gonna ask you to start with the crepes. So we're gonna pile them up and make that cake
and
right
and
over
look
there.
Look at the end result. It's
and we're
so
gonna start off
with the jam.
A layer of jam, a layer of whipping cream, and then put some strawberries and repeat.
Okay.
You got that?
I think I can do that.
Okay. So I'm gonna start off. I have a little bit of rice flour in here with some tapioca and a little bit of salt.
Okay.
I have here a half a cup of rice milk, and to that I'm going to take 3 tablespoons of the beet juice, and you'll see how beautiful the color will turn.
Wow.
1, 2, and 3. And 2 tablespoons of maple syrup.
Okay.
1, 2. And 1 teaspoon of some vanilla extract. And we mix that all together along with 2 eggs. And voila, we're going to mix that. It's very simple. I usually make my crepes much thinner, but this one we're gonna make it a little bit thicker.
Okay.
Because when you're going to actually make the cake with whipping cream, you're going to realize that it'll be too mushy inside.
If it's too thin.
So
I
make
can't
it a little
how
bit
beautiful
thick.
That final result is. And I mean, you could do this for a breakfast even or for
or
like,
a dessert.
Or a dessert.
It's a dessert.
It's a versatile
for sure.
Crepe.
So I'm going to show you. Look how amazing this color is.
Oh, wow.
Perfect
for Valentine's Day.
I brought a scooper, and this is like this is actually a quarter cup. So I take a scoop of this.
Okay.
I have to mix it
a little bit better.
And then we just pour it into your pan, and then you jiggle around like this until it's all fully coated.
Okay.
And then it takes like a minute on the stove.
Burner.
Yeah.
And then you flip it.
And you don't even have to flip it. Just wait
until
it's...
It's ready?
Side. Yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
And then you cool these, I guess?
You have to cool them, and then you can layer them. You can use like a mascarpone cheese. I mean, this is a whipping cream. You could do a dairy, non-dairy. You can put in strawberry jam, or you can make your own, coulis or something.
Yeah, because by putting the fruits in there, it's another way to add that great color
for Valentine's Day. And it's great. It's great flavor.
Beautiful.
I use the beets as well to make the
red
velvet cupcakes. You know, I'm asked at work all the time to make red velvet cupcakes, and
they're
I can't imagine how I'm going to take that red paste and put it inside. So I made this recipe. It took me maybe 5 times to do it because every time you bake it, it turns brown.
Okay, right.
So that's the nature of the beets. But I found a way. All my recipes that you see here are actually on my website.
Okay.
Or they'll be on my website by the end of the day, I promise.
So, and for people who are like, do you taste the beets? Like, do you taste
it's
it?
It's a bit earthy. But I have to tell you, the topping for the red velvet cupcakes, it takes it all away.
Is that sweet.
Beets are sweet. They're a great fiber and has vitamin C and folate and magnesium. They're very good for your health, but it could be snuck in with a little bit of vanilla and a little bit of chocolate. There's a little cocoa powder in there. it dissipates.
Well, and as you said, if we're going to be eating indulging, why not? If it's an easy way to make it healthier.
Of course.
Just real quick here, you have some, we don't have much time, but you have more treats for us.
Yes. So here are some little tarts that I made. Again, I have the recipe online.
Okay.
And you just put in some jam. You can do that. You can put some jam inside. It's so easy to do. And then you can top it off with a little heart like that. And then you put them in the oven for 5 minutes.
And they're all set.
And they're all set. So you get them like this. And I've also made... Sorry?
Yeah, we're running out of time. But everyone, this inspires definitely to indulge in healthy red treats for Valentine's Day. Thank
Absolutely.
You so much, Miriam. And as you mentioned, they'll be up on your websites, all the recipes. Stay with us. We have a lot more BT coming up next.